Hi, my name is Deepa, and I'm Product Marketing Engineer, and I have with me here Gabe, Applications Engineer, and we're from the Clock and Timing Group of TI. Today, we're going to look at the system-level benefits and competitive analysis of TI's latest LMK6100 ultra-low-jitter differential oscillator family. The LMK6100 delivers 90 femtoseconds of RMS jitter and is perfect for any applications that require ultra-low jitter, such as data and telecom equipment, medical imaging, and any jitter-sensitive high-performance industrial application. The LMK6100 comes in three flavors of fixed frequency, pin-selectable, and fully programmable with integrated EEPROM, and they are offered in the industry standard footprint of 5x7. So Gabe, what have you got here for us on the bench today?
Well, Deepa, we have two experiments showing the performance of the LMK6100 family. This is the LMK61E2 fully programmable oscillator EVM. Here you see the IC connected to the Balun and the E5052B signal source analyzer. As you see here, we have our 156.25 megahertz carrier with a 93 femtosecond performance between 12 kilohertz and 20 megahertz. Let's look at a second experiment. This is the LMK61E2 EVM acting as a reference clock for a 10 gig SERDES link on TI's proprietary ASIC. This is the lossy backplane for the SERDES link. We ran a bit error rate test for about 30 minutes using our competitor's part, and the results you see on the screen are the results of that experiment. By simply replacing the competitor's part with TI's oscillator, we see an improvement about 5x.
That's great, Gabe. So by just merely swapping out the competitor oscillator, we were able to see about 5x improvement.
That's right.
And this is a 10 gig link. So as data rates increase to 25 gig, the effect of this low jitter will be even more compounded in terms of a bit error rate improvement.
That's correct.
That's great. Another thing that designers are always concerned about, Gabe, is how robust their design is, especially in the presence of supply noise. How does the LMK6100 fare with regards to the competitor oscillator in that regards?
Well, let's look at an experiment showing just that. If we look at the eye diagram of the SERDES link without the presence of noise on the power supply, we see the eye here. This translates to about 41.2 picoseconds of total jitter. By injecting noise on the competitor's part, we can clearly see the eye is degraded severely, limiting the overall throughput of the link. Looking at the total jitter with noise on the power supply on the competitor's part, there's now about 72 picoseconds of total jitter. That's a big difference. Now, let's switch over to TI's oscillator and look at the difference. Okay, so now we've replaced the competitor part with our LMK6100 EVM. Now, let's look at the transmit eye again using TI's oscillator without noise on the power supply. Let's see how this translates to total jitter. This correlates to about 41 picoseconds total jitter, just like the competitor's part. Now, if we inject noise on the power supply, we can see the impact on the eye. Notice how there is little to no degradation on the eye. The superior PSRR of the LMK6100 family shows little to no impact on total jitter on the TXI.
That's great, Gabe. So literally minimal degradation on the eye. And this is because of the 6100 family having integrated on-chip LDOs.
That's right.
That's great. So we looked at the great performance, the system level benefits of the LMK6100 family of oscillators. For more information, please visit ti.com/oscillators. Thank you for watching.